Hey friends, welcome back. I have been putting off making this video. I actually recorded the entire thing and ended up scrapping it, but I figured I needed to go ahead and make it because I have been a little bit less active on here. I haven't been posting as often and you guys deserve to know why. So here we go. I have a genetic disorder called Ehlers-Danlos Syndrome. I've had it my entire life. I recently found out that I have it just about 3 weeks ago. It's not contagious, you can't catch it, you don't get it from your lifestyle, you're born with it. It's a defective gene that causes your body to produce faulty collagen, faulty connective tissue. Because connective tissue is throughout your entire body, Ehlers-Danlos syndrome affects numerous body systems, your GI system, your musculoskeletal system, your nervous system, your respiratory system, your skin, your cardiovascular system. The ligaments and tendons are lax and overstretched, so the muscles have to take up the slack, and your muscles are basically holding your joints in place instead of your ligaments and tendons. So your muscles are constantly working, constantly contracted all day long just to hold your body together. And that's one of the reasons why we're so fatigued all the time and why we have knots and muscle pain and spasms constantly, because our muscles aren't supposed to do that. Your ligaments and tendons are supposed to do that. But in our case, our muscles are doing the work of the ligaments and tendons. There are 14 different known types right now. All of them have a genetic cause identified, a mutation in the gene, except for one type, but they are currently working on that right now. They're doing massive genetic studies to identify that gene. So how does Ehlers-Danlos syndrome manifest? Just because you can touch your thumb to your forearm, which most people cannot do, they cannot touch their thumb all the way, lay it alongside their forearm. That's one of the diagnostic criteria, just one, for Ehlers-Danlos syndrome. But just because you can do that doesn't mean that you have Ehlers-Danlos syndrome. So when you see someone with EDS, you know, show you a hypermobile movement or a flexible movement, don't just go, oh, well, I can do that too, I must have EDS. Or, you know, I can touch my toes, or I can put my hands behind my back, I must have EDS. Or my skin's a little bit stretchy, I must have EDS. It's a whole lot more than that. Those are just a few of the diagnostic criteria. You can see here some of the hypermobility that I have. My skin is hyperelastic. It's not extremely hyperelastic. It's somewhat mildly hyperelastic. I also have hyperflexibility of my finger joints. My fingers hyperextend backwards quite easily. It's very difficult for me to push buttons or snap snaps. My thumbs go backwards much farther than a normal person, and I have some arthritis already beginning in the bases of my thumbs. My shoulders are very hypermobile, as you can see here. My shoulders are my main problem areas right now. It's very difficult for me to do things like cook or write or do my hair or anything that requires me to lift my arms. I've had to give up a lot of things. I had to give up gardening. Many of you guys have followed me for my Back to Eden garden videos, and I had to completely let the garden go because it was too painful for me to get up and down off the ground, and the heat would just completely exhaust me. I have very little tolerance for heat or cold. I had to give up milking my goats because I tried milking them this spring and immediately developed tendonitis and bursitis in my shoulders and my arms, so I couldn't do that anymore. I've had to give up lettering. I have started using my right arm more to do things in the kitchen like cooking, and this shoulder and this elbow have started acting up since I've been doing that. This is so hard to talk about, y'all. I don't like talking about myself, and I don't like talking about my issues, but we're just gonna go ahead, okay? So if I've had this my whole life, why did I just now find out that I have it? Well, I have been dealing with pain, chronic, widespread pain in multiple joints, my neck going out, my shoulders going out, muscle spasms. I've had a total hip replacement at age 26. I have a scar from here to here where I had my chest cracked open and put back together because I had a deformity of my chest called pectus excavatum. I have had other surgeries. I've had chronic GI issues my entire life. I have a whole lot of other problems that I'm not gonna go into, but that I always just thought was either normal, that everybody struggled with this, or I found a reason to kind of explain it away. Well, maybe I just worked too hard, or I expended a little too much energy, or maybe I don't exercise enough, or maybe my diet isn't quite right, or growing pains. That was one of the excuses when I was younger and had a lot of issues. And I remember one day I was at our chiropractor and I told him, you know, such and such pain was occurring in my body. And I said, but that's just normal for me. He looked at me and said, that's not normal. It's not normal for your first waking thought every morning, the first sensation you're aware of when you wake up is pain. It's not normal to have your heart rate go up to 130 to 150 just standing up off the couch. Those sorts of things that I just assumed were normal because they were part of my everyday life, to just get fatigued from doing one load of laundry and feeling like I just have to lay down and rest, or walking down to get the mail and coming back and having to rest. If I take a shower or a bath, I have to lay down and rest for half an hour just to bring my heart rate back down to a normal level. How did this all get started? How did I even figure out that this is what I had after all these years? Well, it really was just, you might say by accident, I say by the providence of God. I had gone to a functional medicine doctor to get prolotherapy for this shoulder because I hoped maybe that would help with some of the shoulder pain I was having. When I was there, he mentioned the possibility of a connective tissue disorder. Now, at the time, he didn't diagnose me, he didn't give me a full examination because we were just there to get the prolotherapy and that was it. But since then, I have looked into Ehlers-Danlos syndrome, and when I first looked it up, it was basically my entire life. Like, check, 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 my entire life. All the things that I've dealt with my entire life were explained by Ehlers-Danlos syndrome. Well, since then, I have been to a couple of different doctors and I have been officially diagnosed with Ehlers-Danlos syndrome. I'll be starting physical therapy next week, and I also have a cardiology appointment to make sure that my heart and everything, my aorta, is all okay, because cardiac abnormalities are very common with EDS. I also have a significant heart murmur, so they're gonna check that all out, make sure that's okay. So a lot more people have Ehlers-Danlos syndrome than is known, and it often goes undiagnosed or misdiagnosed, like it was for me my whole life, because the modern medical industry likes to chop the body up into little pieces. They don't look at the body as a whole. And they'll say, well, you have a GI issue, so let's send you to a gastroenterologist. Well, you have a cardiac issue, so let's send you to a cardiologist. Well, you have some bones and muscle problems, let's send you to an orthopedist. But they don't look at the whole body and they don't ask, why is she having all of these different issues? Why is this 17-year-old girl having these issues? Why is this otherwise, you know, healthy, vibrant 20-year-old having a hip replacement? Why are all these things going on? And there's a saying in the EDS community that if you can't connect the issues, think connective tissue. So it's a catchy way of remembering. And hopefully more doctors will become aware of EDS, and when they have patients that come in that seem to have all of these different unrelated problems, they will think maybe it is a connective tissue disorder because it affects virtually every system in your body. Some of the things that go along with EDS are a condition called POTS. It stands for postural orthostatic tachycardia syndrome. Basically, it means that when you go from lying to standing or from sitting to standing, your heart rate skyrockets and your blood pressure drops. For me, my blood pressure is always very low, and when I stand up, my heart rate shoots up and I get very dizzy and almost pass out. I have to get up very slowly. And that, in the case of someone with EDS, is because the connective tissue in our vessels, in our blood vessels, is weak and lax and stretchy. So instead of those blood vessels contracting like they would in a normal person and keeping your blood pressure up so that your heart rate can be down, they are loose and stretchy. And so your blood pools in your legs and your heart has to beat much faster to keep your blood pressure up and keep you from passing out. Another issue that I struggle with every single day is sleep. For years and years and years, I haven't been able to get a good night's sleep because I wake up in pain. So I will go to sleep in one position and my shoulder will go out. It will, it's loose in the socket, and so it moves out of place and it compresses the nerve, and my entire arm will go numb and my fingers will tingle and my whole arm will ache like like it's bruised, like the whole arm is bruised, and then I will have to wake up and roll over, change position. I also have to move very carefully. Anytime I move, if I'm picking up my kids or if I'm climbing stairs or getting in and out of a vehicle or even rolling over in bed, most people don't even think when they roll over in bed. I have to consciously think about every movement, because if I move too quickly or I put pressure on the wrong body parts, a joint will go out. My neck is the one that most commonly goes out. I have a lot of cervical instability. So I've rolled over in bed before and heard a pop because I didn't move correctly and my neck went out, my whole neck spasmed up, and then I'm done. I'm out for 2 days. I can't move, or when I do move, it's so painful that it brings me to tears. So that's something that over the years I've been able to have those episodes less, but just because I'm more careful and I'm moving less. So I've greatly restricted my lifestyle. I don't leave the house very often, and when I do, my husband drives. I don't go shopping anymore. My husband shops for me. There's a lot of things that it has done to limit my lifestyle. And that's why I love doing this for you guys, because it's a way that I feel like I can interact outside of the four walls of my home. And hopefully what I am experiencing, some of you maybe have experienced or are experiencing and you don't know why. So maybe this will give you some answers. Definitely go and look up EDS, Ehlers-Danlos Syndrome. Check out the new 2017 diagnostic criteria. The old diagnostic criteria is obsolete now. They have a new diagnostic criteria that encompasses a lot more than just hypermobility. Whew. I did it. I talked about it. I wanted to let you guys know so that you know what's going on with me when I don't post for 2 weeks or 3 weeks or a month, and also to raise awareness for EDS. If you have EDS, if a loved one has EDS, if you want to know more about EDS, please put in the comments. I would love to interact with you. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you for sharing this part of my life. Thank you for understanding. Have a beautiful day. Like and subscribe. Bye-bye.